We're going to start with our module 3, okay, and we call this module, module 3. We call this module Paradigm Shifts and How to Build an Organization, okay. One of the most important things that you must have is the right frame of mind, okay. Attitude, I've seen this many times. Attitude determines altitude. Okay, I'm sure you've seen these motivational posters that carry this. And that's very, very true, not just in this business, but in every endeavor that you undertake. Your attitude, your strategy, your outlook on the business will determine how big your organization will get. Okay, one of the keys to succeeding in this business is understanding and accepting that most traditional strategies and concepts are not always totally applicable in this business. Okay? We have in this room about 200, 220, 230 people, all of which, all of you have come from your different fields of expertise, okay, and I'm sure you all have your training and your knowledge from the different fields of business that you're involved with, and these are all great, okay, if you're doing those businesses, okay, but we have to accept that many times the strategies that you need to make this business work, okay, are different, okay. Fortunately, the strategies for this business are much simpler, but still you have to accept the fact that it's different. If you were a basketball coach and you wanted your team to win, okay, you don't use basketball strategies for swimming, okay, and you don't use swimming strategies for basketball. If you're a basketball coach, you use basketball strategies. If you're a swimming coach, you use swimming strategies. You don't use badminton strategies, let's say, for soccer. It's completely different. It's all strategies, but different. Okay, we just have to accept the fact that in this business, okay, you need to change some of the traditional mindsets that we have. Okay, and I'm not saying that these traditional mindsets don't work or that they're not worth anything. Okay, I'm just saying that for this business, they're not always applicable. Okay, for example, okay, in traditional business and the corporate world, one of the key thoughts is, the more connections you have, or the more contacts you have, the better off you're going to be. Okay? Haven't we heard that before? Right? If you are, let's say, if you were to start a restaurant, let's say in, I don't know, let's say Germany. Okay? You just landed in Germany. Okay? And you're an expert chef, and you want to set up a restaurant, and you set up a restaurant in Frankfurt. You don't know a single person in Frankfurt. Okay. On the other hand, we have here Bernard, you know, who's lived in Frankfurt all his life. He has a web of connections all around in the different sectors of society, and he decides to put up a restaurant in Frankfurt. Which restaurant would you think would have a higher probability of succeeding? Bernard's, right? Because he has more connections. Okay, more people will know about it right away, and more people will start coming to his restaurant. That's the traditional mindset. Okay, and remember, I use the word mindset because, you know, paradigm shifts means that you have to shift your mindset. Okay, and the paradigm shifts that I'm going to ask you to go through this afternoon are not going to be done only today. You're going to have to keep going through them on a daily basis, because it is difficult to get rid of a mindset. Okay, it's something that you have to exercise every day. And since we were little students, since we were young students, we were taught that the more connections you have, the better off you're going to be. Okay, I know many parents that struggle hard and work very hard so that they can send their children to the best schools, not only for the education, but for the connections. Because let's face it, the world works with the buddy boy system, right? If you have somebody, let's say, in a high position here, and he's looking for people, he's like, oh, I went to school with this guy. You know, oh, he's a relative of my cousin, and my cousin says he's trustworthy. Okay, that's just the way it is. That's the way it is in the world. And that's why many, many parents work hard to send their children to the best schools for the, not just for the education, but also to establish connections, to establish a network. Okay? In sales, it's the same thing. The thought is, the more sales you make, the more money you earn. Okay? Which is great for sales. Okay? If you were doing a sales job, that's great. The more sales you make, and even in sales, if you were a sales manager and you were recruiting salesmen or potential salesmen, don't you look at also their network of connections and contacts, right? Oh, I want to get this guy. He knows half of Kuala Lumpur. Oh, yeah, this guy, you know, knows half of Singapore. He'd be great to set up a distributorship of brake parts with this guy because he has a lot of connections, okay? Many times people fail because they bring that thought into this business. Oh, and I hear it day in, day out. Okay, and for sure many of you are going to have probably fallen into that thought process. Now, remember yesterday I asked your permission if I could speak the truth. Okay, does that permission still hold for today? Okay, can I still speak the truth up here? You're not going to throw your glasses at me just because I say something because I've heard, Joe, he's talking about me. Okay? No, I'm not. I'm talking about things in general. Okay? I've heard it many, many times, and I'm sure many, many people probably today still have the same mentality when they go out trying to do their Gold Quest business. Oh, I want to bring this guy in. This guy knows half of the neighborhood. Oh, I want to bring this guy. This guy's influential. Oh, this guy sits on top of this organization. You see what I'm saying? How many have fallen prey to that mindset? We have a few very honest people here. And hey, I fell into that mindset too. So I'm not excluding myself from this list. Okay, it's a very common thought because again, that's the way we were brought up. Oh, I want to bring this guy in because he has many connections. I want to bring this guy in because he has many connections. If this business was only for people that were well connected and had a lot of contacts, then it's not for everyone. Then what we talk about during our business presentations is a lie. Isn't the reason why this business is so attractive is because everybody can do it? Yes. But does everybody have a lot of connections? No. Okay? So we have to look for something else. We have to get rid of that mindset. Okay? In this business, if you want to work, learn how to use what we call your circle of influence. Okay? It's supposed to be sphere of influence, but it's harder to pronounce. Sphere. Sometimes when I'm here doing the training, I'm here. Learn how to use your sphere of influence. So now it's circle of influence. Anyway, it's the same thing. Okay? Not everybody may have 1,000 connections. Not everybody may have a network of 10,000 people under them. But everybody has a circle of influence. Correct? When I say circle of influence, I'm talking about a group of people who trust what you say. There's about 3 people nodding their heads. The other people have no circle of influence. Will you not agree with me when I say this? Okay, when I came into this business, I brought in 2 people. Okay, I started out as a customer just like you guys. I went into the mall and I saw, how do they call this? Ferdy Tolentino. How many know Ferdy Tolentino? How many have heard of him? Okay, you'll hear about him more often in the near future. He's one of our top earners in this business. I ran into him in the mall, okay? And he was going down the escalator. I was walking, and you know, he was like, Joe, hey, Ferdy, hi. And I go, you know, are you still with so-and-so company? I was involved with another guy. No, I've already quit there. And he goes, you've quit? Because I was doing very, very well with that company. And he goes, what are you doing now? Oh, Gold Quest. And he was like, oh, Joe, I'm in. And I go, wait, can I show you the plan? No, he was going down the escalator. No, I can't. I'm in a hurry. Call me tomorrow. Let's meet. You show me the plan. But, you know, he's going down. He's going, count me in, okay? I'm in. Don't leave me out. You know, and he goes down. And this is my first day, okay? And I was like, wow, this is going to be easy. Man, I'm going to make a lot of money in this. No, this is true, okay? My cousin, the same thing. I talked to my cousin. She had just gone through a very painful divorce, okay? And she told me, Joe, I'm going to do this business, okay? I don't know too much about it. I don't know this company very well, but because you're in, I'm in too. That's basically what she said. If you tell me it's good, I'm in. That's what I mean by circle of influence. Okay, I made $15,000 my first 4 weeks in this business. 14,800 something. Okay, I don't know the exact amount, but you know, change for the boys. Okay, and I brought in two people. Okay, many people thought, oh yeah, you made that kind of money because you had 20,000 people in another network, blah, blah, blah. No. I started from scratch, okay, and I ran into Ferdy. He was a friend of mine. And you know, later on, 2-3 months later, I asked Ferdy, I said, Ferdy, I mean, 2 days after that, I met with Ferdy and I showed him the plan. I showed him the business. You know, we met in a coffee shop near the escalator where we first met, and I sat down. We were having a cup of coffee in this French bakery, and I got the, you know, the, what do you call that, the placemat, the paper placemat. You know, I turned it over, okay, and I started showing him the business plan, okay, and the more he got excited, okay, he couldn't sleep, okay, so he came in. But I asked him 2-3 months later, Ferdy, you know, why, how come I didn't even explain the business to you when you said, you know, you wanted in? He goes, because I know you. I know that you take this business very, very seriously. And I know that if you've joined a business that you've examined it, you've looked at it, you know, you. In other words, he trusts what I say. That's the bottom line. Okay, now everybody has a circle of influence, right? Right. You don't sound convinced. You may not, I see, I always talk about the two people that said yes and I made all of this money, okay, because I only had two directs. Believe it or not, I had only two directs, okay, Ferdy on my left side and my cousin Odette on my right side, okay. The first month earned about 15 plus, the next month about 26, 27, the next month about 32, still with only two directs, okay. So you don't need a lot. But I don't talk about the 40 or 50 people that told me I was nuts, that I was crazy, that I was chasing after the proverbial pot at the end of the rainbow. I don't talk about those people, okay? Because there were 40 or 50 people that told me I was nuts. I had one lady, okay, and my dad knows this lady, who literally laughed me out of her office. Okay, she screamed at me. She was angry. She's laughing. She laughed me out of her office. Okay, I mean, that's how bad. And of course, just like you guys, I was extremely discouraged. I was demotivated. Oh, I'm gonna make all of this money. I've only brought in my cousin and for, and I was very, very depressed. I got depressed. Yes, I do get depressed. Some people, Joe, you get depressed? Yes, I'm just like you guys. Of course, 2 hours later, I wasn't depressed anymore. Okay, but anyway, I used to think that it was such a big blow to my career in this business. I didn't realize that it was a blessing in disguise, okay, that all these people turned me down, okay. I'll explain that in the second paradigm shift, okay. But anyway, the point I'm trying to make is your friends, your relatives and colleagues will join you in the business not because of Gold Quest, not because of GQI, but because of you. You see what I'm saying? They will join because of you. Because of your influence. influence over them. Now, you may not be influence, you may not be able to influence 50, 60, 100 people, but for sure, you'll be able to influence two, three, four, five people. Correct? Most people have a circle of influence of about what? Some people say 10, some people say 20, some people say 5. I think 3 people is a safe amount. Correct? Or safe number. How many will agree that most people have a circle of influence of between 3 to 5 people? That's a conservative figure, correct? Okay, let's say 4. Okay, let's say 4. Will everybody agree that that's a pretty safe number? You may not be able to go out, you know, and ask and convince 100 people to join you in this business that we call Gold Quest. But 2, 3, 4, 5, I think that's a number that most people can deal with, right? So let's talk about that number, okay? Like I said, you may not be able to convince 100 individuals in GQI business. However, 2, 3, 4, 5 people, I think, is not too much of a task, okay? How many people in this room think, okay, that they can be successful in inviting and you know, referring 3, 4, 5 people to this business? That's easy because most of you have done it already. How many have done that already? How many are still doing it? Because we have people that are new. Okay. But you also feel that 2, 3, 4 is okay. Okay, because look what happens. If you just use your circle of influence, okay, this is you, okay, again, you may not know 10,000 people, you may not have a circle of influence, but for sure your brother, okay, who's looking for a new business, you have a colleague, you know, whose wife is pregnant and is looking for you know, additional income, you know, to support his future family. Then you have another office mate, you know, who's thinking of relocating and he needs a new business. Okay, just 2, 3, 4, 5 people. Now these four people, will they also have their circle of influence? Yes. They will also have 2, 3, 4 people that will trust them, right? And these people will come into GQI as a business not because of you, but because of them, because of their influence. Okay, then pretty soon, they start growing. If you just sit down and busy yourself with helping them bring in their circle of influence, what happens now? Now you have an organization, right? Now it's starting to build. Does it make a difference to these people, to the computer? Okay, does it make a difference that these people are not your directs? Doesn't make a difference, right? Because the GQI system does not consider that. All the GQI computer system realizes is that, hey, this guy's left and right is building. Correct? Now, if there was a premium for direct and indirect, then this strategy doesn't work. If you have, let's say, 5 and 5 direct referrals, I mean, you personally brought in these 5, okay, and you get $800, but if you get 5 and 5 and they're all indirect, and you only get $400, then, like I said, this doesn't work. But there is no premium for direct or indirect referral. The computer doesn't care. As long as you have 5 on the left and 5 on the right, how much do you get? US 400. So if the computer doesn't care, why should you care? Does it make a difference that all these people came in because they were in the circle of influence of somebody else? No, it doesn't. Doesn't make a difference. It doesn't distinguish between a direct referral and an indirect referral. Okay? So if it doesn't make a difference to the computer, it shouldn't make a difference to you. Okay? If you just busy yourself with assisting your five, bring in their five, and bring in their five, etc., etc. If you just busy yourself with that, okay, your organization will grow and you will prosper financially. Okay? Let's make it very clear. Because many, many times, people have the thought that, oh, I'm going to purchase a coin, okay, and I'm going to bring in 10. How many thought that way in the beginning? In fact, many, many articles that I've read, okay, not just in this country, but many, they think that you have to bring in the 5 by yourself. But that's not so. It doesn't make a difference. Whether you get 5 that are your directs, the green represents your personal direct referrals. Okay, how much do you get? If your organization looked like this, 400. But if you have indirects that came in 5 and 5, how much is that worth to you? $400. It's the same thing. Okay, it doesn't make a difference. The mistake that most people make after bringing in their quote unquote 4. Okay. There's one really big, see, this came about because one time I was in Singapore conducting a training and somebody came up to me and during the training, he kept asking, oh, you know, I've been rejected so many times. Oh, everybody's giving me their objections. Oh, this and that. Finally, after the training, I went to him, okay, and I said, you know, sir, I'm going to be here for the next 2 or 3 days. Okay, I took pity on him and I said, you know, can I help you go out and get your left and right? You know, I'll help you. And he goes, no. I already have my left and right. I said, you do? Yeah. I have 2 on my left and 3 on my right. So I said, well, what's the problem? You know, but I've talked to 50, 60, 70 people over the last 4 or 5 days and they all turned me down. And that's when it got me thinking. This guy's approaching it wrong. What happened now is those 2, 3, 5 people, okay, that he was talking about, he just basically left them alone. What he did is he went out and he tried to bring in 100 people by himself. And they usually end up just neglecting. They go out and try and refer 100 more people by themselves. That's the mistake that this guy was making. Okay, and that's why he was failing. He was getting so discouraged. So what happened? I said, what happened to your 2 on the left and 3 on? And he goes, what do you mean? I don't know. They're supposed to go out and refer. They're supposed to go out and make money for me. That was this guy's mentality. Is that the way to make money in this business? So what happens is, usually they end up not continuing in the business, right? Because somebody brings them in and then leaves them alone and that's it. They know nothing about the business, they've never been trained, they've never been caddied. And they end up just getting discouraged and not continuing in the business. Which is something that we're going to be taking up a little bit later. You know, why do people drop out? Why do people who were otherwise very excited about doing this business eventually end up dropping out of the business? Usually it's because they don't have support. Okay? So they end up not continuing in the business. What you must realize is that you must be patient. You're not going to be able to bring in half of Singapore or half of KL by yourself. Okay? The sooner you realize that, the better off you're going to be. Remember, this is not a get-rich-quick scheme. Okay, this is not something where you make money instantly, you know, your first day or your first week. Start setting a culture of encouraging others to assist their directs in referring their circle of influence. You see what I'm saying? That's where building an organization, that's how building an organization starts. It starts by you helping them. See, what happened was, Ferdy came in, right? Now he calls me up the next day, okay, and says, Joe, I have a group of people I'd like to talk to. Can you meet with me? Okay, because I don't know how to present it the way you do. So I said, yeah, sure, what time? Tuesday, 7 o'clock. I remember the date. So we met in Pizza Hut on Ortigas in the Philippines. Okay, we met at Pizza Hut, and Ferdy was there with a small group, about three or four people. One of them was Dave Trinidad. To this day, I'm so thankful to God that Dave Trinidad was there. I didn't know Dave Trinidad. Okay, but did it make a difference to the computer? No. So I sat there, showed the business, okay, and Dave took one look. Okay, how do we do this? How do we start this business? I'm like, wow, this is my kind of guy. Okay. And then on my cousin, on the other hand, she said, Joe, I'm having some friends over. Come to the house. Okay, can you help me present it to them? I said, yeah, just make sure there's a whiteboard. Okay. And she didn't have a whiteboard. Okay. So what we did is we took, you know, the brown paper, the big sheets, we just pasted it on the wall, you know, with tape, and when I ran out of space. And one of the guys in there was T.G. Quintanar. And then T.G. Quintanar asked me to help present in his house to some of his friends. And then another presentation, then came in Rico Uy. And then Rico Uy came in the same time with Patrick Zuniga. You see what I'm trying to say? I didn't know these people. But all I did was just kept helping them bring in their two or three. See? Had I left them alone, do you think they would have prospered? Maybe yes, but in all probability, probably not. Okay, because the people need support. The only way you can start this culture is to do it yourself. Don't expect to bring in one person on your left, another person on your right, and you go, you make money for me, you go, make money for me. But sadly, many, many people have that mentality. I brought you in, you're supposed to bring in me all your clan. What about you? You're supposed to bring in your whole school. I thought you were a good guy. That's not the way to make money in this business. And if you start that kind of culture, you know why that's so dangerous? If that's the way you are, how do you think they're going to treat their leaders in their organization? They're going to treat them exactly the same way. But if you busy yourself helping out these people, how are they going to treat their customers? Exactly the same way. And that's the reason why this paradigm shift, number one, is so important, because it sets the tone. It sets the tone for your culture in your organization. The only way you can start this culture is to do it yourself. Help others bring in their circle of influence. The numbers will come later. Okay, can you imagine if this is you and you bring in year four, right? Now, how long will that take? If you, with the help of the leaders up in your organization, really decide to spend time in bringing in your circle of influence, how long will it take? Somebody says 1 week. Somebody said 2 days. 1 month. 2 months. However long, huh?
4 months.
4 months. That's very long. Let's say 1 month. Let's say 2 months. Okay? Is that acceptable to everyone? 2 months to bring in four people within your circle of influence. Not by yourself, but with the help of your leaders. Right? Now, these four will also have their circle of influence, right? These guys aren't hermits. They don't live up in a cave up in them hills up there, right? They also have a circle of influence. They also have friends, relatives, and cousins. Everybody has a circle of influence. See, for this business to work, you have to make it work with something that everybody has. And everybody has a circle of influence. If you don't have a circle of influence of two or three or four people, people who believe you, people who trust what you say, then this is the wrong seminar. Then you should be attending another. If you can't get two, three, four people to believe what you say and can bring home the integrity with which you explain something to them, then you're attending the wrong seminar. But remember, everybody has a circle of two, three, four, five people of influence over them. Now, these four will have also two, three, four, five people under them, correct? So now, if you just help the four bring in their four, now you have 20 in your organization. Do you know these 16 people? Does it make a difference if you know them? Doesn't make any difference. Now, these 16 will have a circle of influence of four. Will you be alone in assisting these 16? Will not the four help you out? Depends. If you help them out, if you took time out to help them, then they probably will help you too. But if you just left them alone, they probably won't help you enlarge your organization. Now, these 16, these 64, are they hermits? No, they also have friends, relatives, colleagues. When the 64 bring in them, then you have 256 coming in. Again, do you know these people? Doesn't make a difference at the computer whether you know them or not. Then the 64 have a circle of influence of 2, 3, 4, 5 people. Now you have 1,000 coming in. 1,000 people you don't know, but your organization help bring them in. Help refer them into this business. That's how you make money in this business. Teach everyone to work with their circle of influence. The first thing is accept it here in your heart. Okay, realize that you need to work with your circle of influence, and finally, teach them the same thing. If you have people under you who think, oh, this guy is the president of this organization, oh, this guy is the minister of this, or this guy is a senator in this province, tell him, wait, that's not the way we're going to do it here. Let's work with your circle of influence of about four or five. Then we will work with their circle of influence. Teach it. Remember, this is a business of impartation. Okay, the sooner you can get them with that mindset, the sooner they can teach their leaders also. And the big numbers will come later. I guarantee you, if you do it right, the big numbers, the sales, the volumes, the big checks, okay, this will only be a byproduct, okay, of the way you train and set the mindset in with your leaders. Okay, the numbers will come later.